have to move from a type of teaching and learning that was very rote, preparing people to work in factories, to sit still, to follow directions, to something that engages analysis and synthesis.
It has become the cultural script in this country. When you are in a classroom, teachers have a particular script in their head that they're supposed to stand at the front of the room and they're supposed to impart knowledge to students, and students know that they have a particular role that they play, which is to sit in their seats passively and receive that knowledge.
You can debate, is it more important to get good grades, like a 95 and up, or is it better to gain the actual knowledge throughout your life? Is it better just to score high or learn with, like, from heart?
Diego, very interesting. Starts basically, wake up 6:30, around that time, mom screaming, wake up, wake up. Then you get dressed, wash my teeth, comb my hair, eat breakfast, and then after school. School starts at 7:40. That's when I get to school, I talk to my friends, catch up on the homework if I didn't do or fix it, and then start class.
Diego Negron is a 15-year-old IDEA organizer who got interested after attending the International Democratic Education Conference that was in England this last summer. And he's someone who has been involved in some leadership experiences in the summertime and attends a private school, but is really interested in the education that all kids get in Puerto Rico.
The Democratic Education Movement, it means a hope for the citizens of Puerto Rico. We've had many years of a struggle economically, but most importantly socially.
Overall, most of the people feel that Puerto Rico is in a very bad situation. This is what adults we were able to build. This is what we have constructed, what we have formed as a nation, as a country, as a society, and we failed. So we have to give the opportunity to younger people to see if with new paradigms they can build something better than what we failed doing.
My name is Katie Strom. I'm a doctoral student at Montclair State University, getting my doctorate in teacher education and teacher development. I'm also involved in the Newark-Montclair Urban Teaching Residency in a couple of capacities. I serve as an induction coach, so I'm mentoring our first cohort of graduates who are now in their first year of teaching. Our tradition of education in terms of teacher as teller, in terms of teacher as possessor of knowledge and transmitter of that knowledge to students who are, as Paulo Freire said, empty receptacles, it's virtually been unchanged throughout history for the past two millennia. Those who are in power, they are imparting the dominant forms of knowledge and the status quo along with those dominant forms of knowledge to the students. So the students are effectively being indoctrinated into the dominant ideology while they're sitting in those seats.
So if democratic education is about giving people the skills and tools to move forward and create democratic societies, a core part of where we're headed in the next 25 years is less regurgitation of simplistic facts and more synthesis, more analysis, more making connections between things.
Me and my partner, Daniel Cruz, we needed to do a science plan because we're in advanced chemistry. And usually that's a boring task, you know, doing research and then getting a board, basing things, and then presenting it to a judge. It's for a jury, it's a really long process. I need to find a way to mix these school and the work so I wouldn't have so much to do. So me and Daniel thought of a way to join these, which was making a sanctuary project that involved an effective analysis of both educational systems, which are democratic and the direct method.
We were really wondering which one we like more, first of all, and which one really proved more effective, because maybe you like one or the other, but they don't really benefit you.
And when we talk about traditional versus inquiry, they're not diametrically imposed. There's absolutely a continuum. But when we talk about traditional teaching, students are positioned as not knowing, as not having resources, and their job is only to passively receive the knowledge, so they don't engage with it. And in order to learn, you do have to engage meaningfully with information.
Can you explain, talk with the teacher to make sure that she understand it. She understood. Sorry. Basically, everything that she had to do, she understood every method, so she could like execute it the way we wanted it in her classroom. And we used different after the classes. We gave the students a quiz to determine like if it really worked, the methods, and it ended up like it was slightly different. The direct method, it had 3% more in the percentage of the student scores. But we saw that in a wider range, the direct method, we had like really good grades and then really bad grades. And the medium ended up that the inquiry-based method had a higher like effectivity between this.
In terms of Diego's findings for his project, I was not surprised at all. He had, in fact, I was surprised that there wasn't a larger margin in favor of the traditional style of learning, simply because there's a certain amount of conditioning that's happened. By the time students get to Diego's grade in ninth grade, they've been through many years of that traditional teaching style where they've been conditioned to be those passive receivers. And so, in flipping the script, because it becomes culturally integrated, this idea of our role in the classroom. So in flipping that script, there is some major disequilibrium. There is, an uncomfortableness. And that definitely can lead to resistance on the part of students because we're asking them to be vulnerable in a way and put themselves out there in a way that they may not have been before, to engage with their learning in a more active way that they may not have been asked to do previously.
The teachers, their goal is to teach the students for a long term. They don't just want you to get like an A and then forget it all. Like you don't bottle up everything and then just release it in a test. What teachers wanted, and that's what we explained to the teacher, we want you to know the method you want to use, not the one you want to use, but the most effective one, which we highly recommend that you use it, because you want the students to hold on to that information for future progress, because that's what education is really about.
Teaching and education, it's an extremely complex system with levels of system. So you've got the teacher, you've got the classroom, you've got the school, you've got the larger district, and then you've got your educational policy landscape. So if change is to happen, it has to happen on multiple levels. And that's one reason that I was so interested in working with Diego, because we represent two different levels in the system. Diego as a student and as a community activist in Puerto Rico, and myself as a doctoral student and as a teacher educator. So we advocate for inquiry and fight for change in our own context, but that represents change happening on multiple levels.
We made it. We compared two classes with the same teacher using different methods. And later on, we presented it to the jury. We went to Science Fair award ceremony. Luckily, we got first place. We're going to regionals in April.
When we got up there and we got first place, it was like incredible because we knew that everything that we did paid off.
It not only means that we won and then it shows all our hard work, it also means that the judges, who are adults, are interested in democratic education, or at least show interest in developing these ideas that me and Daniel came up with.
Inquiry-based instruction is one tool, one process that takes the learner at the center and asks their questions about a particular experience and invites that deeper type of learning or thinking. And so the connection, I think, is that it's one way to begin to build some of the skills that we're talking about under the banner of democratic education.
Small events, small change, one teacher educator, one student advocating for change, for inquiry, for democratic education in their local context could potentially have very large impacts on the system as a whole.